I'm sure you agree that pivot tables are a great way to summarize data. But things can get tricky when it comes to handling dates. That automatic grouping of dates can be a bit confusing. And what if you want to have groupings that aren't available there, like your fiscal periods? Also, how can you show all the dates, including the hidden dates, so not just the ones that had numbers reported? It just comes down to having the correct start, which involves a little tiny setting. Let me show you. Okay, so this is my data in Excel. I have information about salesperson, order date, and order amount. Now, I'd like to take a look at order amounts by salesperson for each single month. I could easily do that with a pivot table, right? This is an official Excel table. It's called Table Sales. So I'm just going to go ahead and insert a pivot table from Table Range. Let's go ahead and insert it on a new sheet. I don't have month here, but I have order date. So if I grab date and drag it to the rows, take a look at what automatically happens here. My dates are split into years, quarters, months, and then I have the date itself. Now notice on the pivot table side, I get this automatic grouping added. So if you have Excel 2016 and above, you're going to have this default applied. If you don't want this default to apply, you can go ahead and quickly press Ctrl Z to get it reversed. Now I'm just going to press Ctrl Z a few times to go back to where we were. Now if at this stage I press Ctrl Z, it's going to grab the order date, right? So check this out. I'm going to go drag it here. It's going to do the split. I'm going to press Ctrl Z and it's going to ungroup. Now if you want to ungroup later and you forget about the Ctrl Z thing, you can. You just go right mouse click on your dates and go ungroup and you have your dates back. If you want to have a different grouping to what Excel gives you, you can go and group your dates and select the type of groupings that you need. So remember, before I got quarters, if I don't need quarters, I don't have to select it. So just go and click on years, and then let's go with days as well, and then click on OK. And now I have days, months, and years. So going back to the type of analysis that we wanted to do, I want to take a look at the salesperson. So I'm going to bring salesperson as a filter and let's add order amount as my values. Okay, let's adjust the number formatting as well because this doesn't look so neat. Use a 1000 separator and zero decimal places. Okay, so this way I can take a look at all salespeople or I can select multiple or single salespeople and have a look at their sales. Okay, so far so good. But what if I didn't want to have the dates visible like this? What if I wanted to see Jan 2021, right? And then Feb 2021. And then for this one, I want to see Jan 2022, Feb 2022, and just get rid of the year. Right now, I can't do this because whatever I type in here is replicated here. If you want to be more flexible with the date grouping, you have to use a slightly different approach, which I'm going to show you in a second. Now, another limitation with the pivot table report is that I can't get the dates where I didn't have sales. So let's kick out the months here and bring over the days. Here I can see that Amy had sales on the 16th, the 28th, 29th. But what if I want to get the list of days in January where she didn't have sales? It's going to be a bit difficult for me to calculate that here. So if you want a lot more flexibility with the dates in your pivot tables, you can use this approach that I'm going to show you right now. Okay, so first of all, I'm going to go ahead and delete this sheet, and we're going to start off where we were with a slight difference. So let's go ahead and insert a pivot table from Table Range. Now, instead of just going ahead and clicking on OK, I'm going to place a check mark and add this to the data model and then click on OK. Now what changed? Everything looks the same. If I go and grab order date and drop it in rows, I get that grouping again. Where is the flexibility? Well, the flexibility is in the data model and the ability that you can add your own calendar table. So the moment you add this to the data model, you don't want to do this. You don't want to grab order date and bring it into here. Instead, what you want to do, go to the data tab and bring up the data model, which is this button right here. It's the Power Pivot window. When I open that, we can see our data set added to this window as well. Now, one thing I'm going to do is adjust the formatting of this. So when I create my pivot tables, I don't have to correct the number formatting. So I'm just going to select that and apply the currency format. Now, optimally, if you're using the data model and doing different types of analysis, you want to create measures. But for just quick and simple analysis, we don't really need to worry about that. Now, here's the magic of the data model. If I go to Design, Date Table, I have the ability to add a brand new calendar table to my model. So take a look at what happens. All of this is being automatically generated. I get a list of dates, so a new row for each single day of my data. Now, the way this works is that it takes a look at the smallest date that I have here, and then it creates a list of dates starting from 1st of January of the smallest year, all the way until the end of December of the largest year. Then it adds all these columns. Now notice I have that month-year combination here. And if I have different types of grouping of years, or if I have different fiscal periods, I can add my own columns to this as well. Now there is a single step we need to do before we can successfully use this. And that's to create a relationship between the calendar table and our sales table. And an easy way to do that is just to switch to diagram view so we can see everything a lot neater. Let's just drag this to the side here, and we're going to click on date, drag it, and connect it to order date. That's pretty simple, right? Now, just to make sure that I don't mistakenly use the order date and drag it down like I did before, I'm going to right mouse click and hide this from client tools. This way, I'm going to be using the calendar table and not creating those automatic groupings anymore. Okay, so we've done our major setup. We're just going to go back to our pivot table here. Now, when I switch to all, I can see the calendar table and my sales table. Notice that the date is now hidden. So I'm going to click and drag the order amount here, which comes as perfectly formatted. Let's put salesperson in the filter. And now let's open up the calendar table and take what we need. If I wanted to look at the year and month combination, I can do that. If I want to add the day of the week as well, I can do that as well. Let's just switch these around. Now I can see which day of the week had the highest sales in January. And remember those additional groupings that we had. So if I want to see the month and year combination, I can click and drag this down, and I have the month and year combination. Now, this unfortunately is sorted based on alphabetical order, which I don't want. So I need to adjust the sorting of this. The way the sorting works is that you have to correct that in the data model. So if we switch back to the data model here, and if we go to our calendar table, let's go to data view in the calendar table here, we need to adjust the sorting in this view. And there's a trick around this, and that's to use sort by column. So you can sort a single column by another column. Now, if we take a look at our data set, by which column can I sort this by? I can't sort it by month number because that's going to ignore the years. And I can't just sort this by years because that's going to ignore the month. So it helps here to add a helper column that gets this done. So let's go to this last column here, add an equal sign, and use the information we have from year and month to create something that we can easily sort. One way is just to take our year, so I'm just going to click in there to get the column header, multiply this with 100, and add the month. Now when I press enter, I get my values here. Let's call this YYYMM. Now we're going to go back to this column, sort by column, and sort it by the new column that we just added, and click on OK. So check this out. The moment I switch to Excel, everything is automatically sorted. Now what about getting a list of dates on which we didn't have any sales? Well, let's bring this up to the filters. I'm just going to go and select a single salesperson And let's go with January 2021. Okay, so let's bring the date column from our calendar table to the rows now. And again, just like with our pivot table, the standard view is to see the rows which have values. But remember, in our data model, we have a new row for each single day, even if we didn't have sales. That's in our calendar table. So to be able to view that, we can right mouse click, go to pivot table options, under display, show items with no data on rows, and then click on OK, and we get to see the entire list, including the dates that didn't have sales. If I want to restrict my view to only those dates and just get a report for that, I can go to value filters, equals, let's put a zero and OK, and that gives me the list of dates on which Amy didn't have any sales. Now, what if you're asked to take a look at your data based on quarters? We didn't get quarters automatically added, but we just need to figure out the formula for that. One way to get this done, let's just add a header first, is to use the integer function. So I'm going to start with int. I'm going to open the brackets again, grab the month number, add 2 to this, and then divide this by 3. Close bracket, press enter, and we get the right quarters populated. Now let's go back to Excel, and we should see quarters in here. So I can go and drag this as my filter, and let's drag the month and year combination here as well. So for quarter one, we see 2021 Jan to March and 2022 Jan to March. Now the advantage of using the data model is that you can add other related data as well and just create connections like we did here between your tables. This way, if you had a master data for salespersons, so for example, you wanted to look at the salesperson by region and that had a different master data, you don't have to combine everything with VLOOKUPs into the same table. You just create a relationship or connection between those tables. This is something I cover in a lot more detail in my Power Pivot and DAX course on Excel Plus. Now, another question you might have is that, what if you get more dates, right? What if we go beyond what the calendar table created? So you're going to go to Design, go back to your Date Table options, and update the range. You can manually adjust the start date and the end date. If you want this to be dynamic as well, so it picks up the correct dates based on the data that you have in your sales, you can use Power Query to get this done. And this is also something that I cover in a lot more detail in my course. So if you're interested, check out the description of this video. As you can see, that setting of adding the data to the data model gives you a lot more flexibility. Now, aside from the additional groupings, you also get access to creating easy time intelligence calculations with DAX. I'm curious. Let me know if you're brand new to the data model side of Excel. Just comment with brand new in the comments. As usual, you're going to find the file that I used in this video on my blog post. Link to it is below the video. Thank you for being here. Thank you for watching. Subscribe if you aren't subscribed yet. And I'm going to see you in the next video.